Hello and welcome to Elden Ring. So, last time we beat a boss, we got some runes and we acquired some cool new armor. Is it functionally better? Depends what stats you want in, but sort of. Does it look cooler? Yes. Do I like the color blue, which this armor is? Yes. And that's enough of a reason for me. Right. We will be going to have a look at that other boss. I'm also curious. So, I think we're going to go for that boss. And then I'm considering going back underground. But I will say, this is striking me as probably a fast way to end up somewhere in the middle over here. That's probably where it's going to lead to. It'll probably come up somewhere over there. But this area is also largely unexplored, as is this area leading into the Crimson Rot. But if it turns out that this just leads to somewhere in this area, and we've still got this path over here that leads into the area, and it might be a case of I leave all of that until we are actually going to that area. And for now, we might scout over this way and see what this area is like. I'm unsure which one we're intended to go to next. Because we'll probably find that when we get there, the enemies will probably be kind of level gated to our level. So we should probably just test the areas out and see which one feels easier on the initial entering to the area. So we'll just basically what I'm getting around to is I'm going to dip my toe in, see what feels right, and go with that. Long story short. The main area, the first zone, seems largely explored now. Limgrave here. It feels largely explored. I'm fairly certain we've got most things here. Not all, obviously, we've not been literally everywhere, but I think we've got most of the bullet points, so to speak. We've got most of the major items, and there's just things like this boss here which might give us, I guess, if it's like the other boss, it'll probably be a talisman or something along those lines. Right. Let's have a look. Is there any advice? If only I had a wolf, therefore seek friend. Could this be a dog? Time for jump attacks. I might give that a go, and if it's actually something that helps, I might come back and give you a good thumbs up appraisal there. I'm also kind of wondering what would happen. Because we've not tried this yet. We can supposedly attack these. Do we get anything? Oh, ruin fragments. And they are worth almost no souls. They're worth like 39 souls. But they seem to be a good source of ruin fragments if we're into that sort of thing. I just thought I'd try. I should probably, you know, kill everything at least once unless it's like a named NPC. So... Also, what's that over there, just on that cliff? What is that? Oh, it's a skull. I honestly thought for a moment that... well... Yeah, I was just looking at it, I'm like, what the hell is that? I thought it was something important. No, no. Right, let's go on with the boss then. Now, if I remember rightly, this guy is rather fast attacking and a bit relentless. They're not usually great against... it's not usually a good thing to be using a shield against those sorts of enemies. Also, what talisman have I got? Increases damage taken. We'll see how this works out. Yeah, it's... Oh, it's gonna put a bleeding effect on it, though. seems to do a ton of damage to him. When we first came up across this guy, we were much lower level. I think it was pre killing any bosses, so it's been a long time since we first faced. Yeah, we can just poke him to death. We may have out-leveled this area. Just saying. Bloodhound's Fang. Oh, we're going back through. So we've got an interesting new weapon. It's not upgraded, so we probably won't be replacing ours with it. And I think I've got some cooler stuff than that. But let's have a look. Bloodhound's Fang. Where are we? Actually, yeah, where are we? Bloodhound's Fang. Curved great sword does actually a lot of stuff, and it has a Bloodhound's Finesse, so unique ability. So it is a unique weapon. Oh, I like that. Sort of an attack into a back step. That's pretty good. That I could see, like, against the right bosses, you could use that quite tactically. We'll take off for now. How does it do in terms of damage? Actually, not bad. Actually, 136. So not 136, 141 against my 136. Its strength and dex scaling are quite good. The strength is better than... This is without a Ash of War. I'd be tempted to use that. There's a few really good weapons I'm already finding. I think when I've got some spare upgrade materials, it might be worth just experimenting a bit with them. Oh, how many souls? Oh, well, runes. Barely any at all. I need to figure out what this means at some point as well. That statue that points. On that note though, we'll be off. Now the good news is, now we do have a rapier here. A rapier. Which means the enemies here seem to be more vulnerable to piercing. So, if we just jab at them, we're gonna probably, dare I say, is that why I've not been getting summons when I've been using those things, the finger recipe things in the previous episodes? It probably is, and I'm probably an idiot. Hey! I'm eating venison here, what are you doing? Oh god, he can climb! Jab! 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 Oh, he's gonna spit. I saw him. No, he's not. Ow. Right. I'm not going to be able to resist that as well. I'm just going to be, every time I do this, just, it's either going to be boop or poke. I warn you now. Ah! This is because I ate a bunch of deer, isn't it? Oh, this is not good. There's two of them. It's getting a bit relentless. Okay, actually it's not that bad. I probably didn't mean to do that. Poke. Like micro stun stuff, isn't it? It does just kind of micro stuns them as you hit them, like breaks their poise. This is actually possibly overpowered as a weapon. Especially when you're bringing it back to these lower level areas that I probably should have been to ages ago. Right, oh, and it got me a nice quick 1,000 runes. Get my way through them. Oh, lovely, we're just gonna carve off his rotting flesh. Killing the deer doesn't spawn those deer people in, does it? I mean, we're gonna know soon. It does. Anything? Probably not. I swear if this is another secret passage thing. Bad. Right. Spawning? Nope. Very weird. Right. Oh, what's behind here? Anything good? Nope. Oh, we know if we ever need any bones or anything. Nowhere to go. I'm feeling a little bit emboldened. Ow! I was about to say, maybe we can kill some of these weird glowing magic orb things. Seen as I just killed a load of weird ghosts, but apparently not. Apparently, these things just lighten me. Am I right in think? Oh crap, the crab's back. Dodge, 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 dodge. Crab. Get away, crab. Go away. So it looks like the shoot off. entire the all of the line, and then they just die, I guess. Really? You're getting a bit of a lay of the land in here. What do you have? That helps. That actually helps. Yes, thank you. Right, let's have a look. So we've gone through this first area up to here. Now that's closed off to us. Or that way. But we can rejoin it here. It looks like there's some kind of big tower at the end of it all. That presumably takes us up here somewhere. To there. Right. What the hell are you? Any loot down this side? It does not look like there is. It's a really old, really dead deer. Well, that person doesn't seem to be affected by it. Let's have a look. Could this be a monster? Nope. I mean, if it is, it's a very dead monster. But well, I guess this is where the river ends. As well as everything else, apparently. I wonder if you end up there at some point. I mean, you never know when there's portals in a game, do you? Right. Like someone thought they could make it. I also thought that honestly came back round to the start and you'd be able to go back in, but whatever. Anyway. I'll have a quick look over this side just in case there's anything along the edge. Nope. Well, this was a whole lot of nothing. Looked cool. Seek fire. Alone creature. Seek fire. What if we... Fire. I have sought fire. Okay, it's ignoring the fire. Maybe you have to do something for it to become a boss. That's usually the case. Okay. Drop down and come back up, so... Ah, there is something over there. And we have a jump button now. Dun, 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 dun. Hornbow. versus Hornbow. It does 65 physical versus my 80. So it's not, it's less. It's a whole 15 less. It gets minus one on the bonus for physical. Scale's exactly the same. Both do mighty shot as their ability. But this does 30 magical. So I lose 15 there plus the bonus, so that's one. So I lose 16 physical to gain the 30 magical. Yes, there is something. Careful, careful. Ooh. Okay, that was worth it. Ooh. Jumping around corners is not good. And just clip that side part. Ugh. Right. Let's see what we can do. You're new. Well, you are and you aren't. Ow! Ow! For some reason my sword was unequipped. Gotcha. Okay. Oh, something bad's there. How's that weird one there? It's like a shaman person. They're all gonna attack me now. Be something that you do with that. Precious item. Item of head. Therefore try down. Yes, we've seen that. That's actually a good one. Ritual required ahead and then seek battle. Shield ahead. Hollowhorn grounds. See how effective this rapier is against these enemies. I am very glad I actually waited to come down here. Right. Inverted Hawk Heater Shield. Oh, after all that, we could have just got a heater shield from down here, eh? It only cost us a small amount, and yeah, I think that we would be. Let's just put that. Yes, you clearly need more appraisals, because people are very much not listening to you, are they? Right. No, I don't see a way up there from here. Must be a way to get up to that sort of weird bridge cum aqueduct type structure up there. Right. Now this did say that we need fire. I wonder, here's my theory. There have been like little things around here that we can light. You know, like these. We need to keep an eye on that, so two are lit. As we go, will more and more of them become lit? My fear is that they will. I think more and more of them will become lit until we eventually have them all lit and it activates the boss. That's my assumption. I'm not totally sure on it. You never can be really with these sorts of games. From software like to be very... I accidentally... Oh, I wish they would... Armor's cookbook. Okay. Well, we might as well rest. We need a lot more rooms to be able to level up. But I think this is a solid plan. We'll push through. Ah, here's a teleporter. Interesting. Very interesting. Are we upon the bridge? I think it's just shortcutted us ahead. That's the number of enemies, I think that's all it's done. That's murder. That's as tough as weave almost. It's quite funny to be fair. Right. Last one of the group. Give me a health potion. Oh, it did. It's nice when it listens to me. Right. We're no longer recovering as well. Our talismans. They don't... Well, so yeah, our talismans, we swapped them out, so we'll no longer be getting the... little trickle of health we were before, unfortunately. I hear a dung beetle. It's a health one. At a time where I could actually use it. Really hurt and are very large. I almost thought for a minute the sheep was going to kill me. Is it? A rune art from a rat. Okay, interesting. Oh god, oh crap! That archer, Jesus Christ! That drained every single bit of stamina I had and practically killed me. Good lord. Beware the archers then, they are very nasty. Right. Let's try that again then. Oh, Christ. Ha ha ha. Oh, I can't lose a big shot anymore. Oh crap, there's a buddy ball at the back of the belt that can. Who's going first? Something vicious. Where have we got? I mean, there's one there, but wasn't there another? Ah, hello. You camping bastard. Right. I'm also kind of curious if there's anything else down here, though. But I'll look around here later. I don't want to be fighting those lightning balls, and I want to get my runes back. But when I died, I looked at my runes and it said 300 and odd, and I'm wondering if it, when I ran over and grabbed them, did it not pick them up? Or did I forget to do it or something? I'm sure I grabbed them. That looks like it's another fire we have to turn on. There's a sniper. You little... That's a different one. Now I'm pinned. Great. And this is lovely on the camera. Run. Thank you. health bar. Sniper. This is a nasty area. Get the hell off of me, Jesus Christ. Great, I've rolled back into more enemies, just what I needed. There. And that's caught every other button. Great. Love Xbox directional pads for that. And I'm dead. Yeah, I'm not getting those soul wounds back. Right, literally cannot cross that open area because there's two of them now for whatever reason. Before, only one of them procs. Only one of them aggroed. Yeah. This time, both of them are there. They've decided that they're both gonna gang up against me and kill me, so we're gonna have to come up with a way to get around that. It's nasty, I've lost half a level worth of stuff. And hell, we could probably kill everything in this area and be lucky to get that back, but anyway, that's how much we lost. But never mind. Right. Out of curiosity, where does this actually go? Let's try one-on-one with this guy. Serves you right. Right, where were we? Say, it does just teleport you forwards through here. From the looks. It's not like, it doesn't look like it's an unreachable area. It looks like it just fast forwards you. Across all of that, if you want. But we could go and explore it perhaps next time. I mean, it's not like we've got souls to get anymore, is it? Oh, and what's this? And half crushed bag up, yeah. Oh no, it's, yeah. I thought for a moment it was clipping into the rock as if it'd been crushed, but now it's just leaning beside it, right. That one's for an Ash of War, isn't it? Square off. Okay. Something to consider. Right. Now. Before we fight that sniper. Has he seen me? Is this too far away to prop? I really hope so. Come on, that must be close. There we go. Annoying, I've not got that. Need to put more damage on this. Really, they just kept. One broke my block and then that big one just charged through and it was, I think because it's like a charge, it counts like a flurry of attacks. Like it ticks for every second or so that they're charging, I guess. And they've just shredded me. Yeah. Unfortunate. But yes, there we go. Look, one of them's lit. So we need to just ignite them all. Confirmed. Right, we're not going after anything, so we can just run through here this time. I want to actually see what's down here, because we've probably missed items and that. We do want to explore the area in its entirety. We're not here to just do the objective. We are kind of here for stuff as well, if possible. We've fought these before, haven't we, when we came up from that ledge. So that's probably a waste of time. Unless they're guarding one of those stones or some items, then I'm going to miss them. Are you guarding a stone? They don't appear to be. So I won't bother with them. Let's see what else we can find down here. Turtle. A lot of turtles. If we ever need like animal bones or anything, this is the place to be. This is the place to be coming. That sniping ability is absolutely dreadful. Of all the things I could have given him. I mean, this may be, because I mean, I am carrying something that increases damage I take, but I think even with that off, I would have probably just got killed there. Basically, we're just going to have to trudge through the area, find all the sniper positions. And then avoid them afterwards. And I've just seen it pop up on the left side. We can do summons. Very nice. Right. Well, that's why we didn't notice them. They literally spawn in like, well, across the ghosts. I wouldn't say live ghosts, but of course they do. It is after all what they are. How I aggroed all three though over here is a mystery. Really no backstab from. Really got to be like perfectly square on that. Right. So what do we have around here? I see why you can probably skip the area with that teleport, because it doesn't look like there's a whole lot here. We can't set this one on fire, can we? No. It looks like there's a whole lot of nothing over here, basically. I do actually think that getting the spyglass would be a good idea. In fact, did I actually buy that? It would be under tools, right? Was that the first one? Yeah, tools. I need to go and buy that. Just being able to like look over there to see if there's some stuff. Because I know the game is a bit hit and miss with its draw distance in places. I'd like to, yeah, there's definitely a, you can go in that tower up there. And there's also an area up this way. As well as that scaffolding up there. And that archway. Oh, if we move further we'll lose our moves. Also, don't forget, there's this one here. Right. Ah, crap. Ow. Shit. Very nice. Okay. I just realised we can actually summon our horse here. But we had them this entire time. Don't know if they'd have made it much easier, but you never know. Okay, they are alert to us. Yeah, that makes it way easier. Okay. But I think we can pop up there, can't we? Don't know what good it would do, but we can. I do believe that's in one of those stones we need. Is he alert to us? He is. That archer's going for sniper shots, probably. Believe him. A lot of them. Ow. Too many at once. Too many at once. There. We'll get on his horse and head back over. We do need to go through it all at some point. So obviously, every one of these needs turning on. It's not about halfway. Summons here, my question. Probably not. Oh, God. Okay, we need to take cover. Get the hell out of there. I'm going to think that there's actually no like maximum range on those. Ow! Get! Got him. like they're looking at something, isn't it? Right. There's this scaffold to investigate as well, isn't there? And yeah, that. It's definitely a lot more down here than meets the eye. Oh, mind you, actually, when you first come down here, it looks massive, isn't it? Yeah, it kind of is. Crap. Need to heal. Not good. I wonder if you could just shoot those with arrows. One, two, three. Yeah, but it's four. Ow! These are not good to be fighting in an enclosed space. Here though, that one got way more recognition. The hell? Right. We're up on the scaffold. Let's see what's up here. Carefully. Sliver of meat. First off, grace. Not helpful. Other guy, helpful. You, no. That's actually a good point. Could I not get round to that from here? I couldn't, could I? No. Could fight with the monsters. It's possible to go in on a fight with them. I'm still good. I'm probably gonna have to. Okay, here we go. I'm doing no damage to them. So we think storms, eh? not that. Let's just get out of the poison. And let's try to actually just loot some of the stuff that's here. Yeah, that's lovely. Okay. We're not going to be able to fight that. I mean, maybe later. I think one on one put is, but when it's like 3-on-1 plus all their ads, and I want to kind of get past them, which involves going to another area where there's another dangerous enemy. They kill their own thing. Grab them, get him. We are doing very little damage. I guess they're not weak to piercing attacks then. It's probably the same with the tentacles, they're probably more of a slashing thing, aren't they? Poison attack. I know you've got a poison attack. They're moving. Now we want to back up. Wait for the poison to go. Shoot all the little lasers off. And now they've just poisoned me. Yeah. But since I'm poisoned, I need to worry about taking poison anymore. Right, we've lost the health that this applies to me, so might as well swap to the recovery thing. Seek campsite and then seek ladder. Thank you. First off, horseback battle and then try jumping. Skip that, so find a campsite and then even better. Yeah, so I think there's a way you could probably jump puzzle this, basically. You don't take status effects on the looks of while you're on your horse, because I remember in that crimson bog, crimson rock bog, can't have a turning circle on this horse, so just try and get it to, there we go. Then The issue is you have to do it slightly before, because it's gonna... There we go. Take a swig. Now we're gonna have to use it to get to that lantern, and then we're gonna have to... The turning circle on the horse makes this difficult. I'll have a quick look outside, see where it actually leads. Might be something really simple and easy to get to. It does not appear so. Where the hell does that even go? Opposite side of it must still be inside a building. Yeah, it is. You can see the wall at the inside, yeah. This will annoy me. Right, let's see. Where exactly do I need to position to get there, guaranteed? Not there. Apparently I can do it perfectly backwards. And it just didn't jump for some reason then. Well, I pressed it, but it didn't do it at first, and then I mashed it a few times and it just did. That time I just bounced off the sides, rare. Holy crap, I made it in. Very daintily. I'm very disappointed. Oh, range battle from here. I suppose it could.
Oh, a customer.
So. Till used for crafting items, butterflies, stone sword keys. Oh, and he's selling them fairly cheap. Ooh, remember this guy. Warrior's Cookbook. Cookbook 18, ooh. Interesting set of wares.
Goodbye.
So from the looks of things, there appears to be some kind of entrance there, and it's very much one way. So somewhere further along, there is a single entrance to this area. Alternatively, go from here. Right. That has completely spent all of my flasks. We have some moons, but it will be worth going back. Mind you, I think there was a site of grace that was being pointed out to me over here, wasn't there? I just rather than going all the way around. Very nice. Not any little crab if we can. And yes, it's a shrine of grace. There we go. And that'll make for a nice stopping off point for the episode. So, thank you very much for watching. We are very far off getting any kind of level up. I don't think we're going to be able to get one in this area, not unless we literally make his way around killing literally everything all in one super run of the area. But now it's, we need to be killing things that drop more runes, I think, to get through to get a level here. But that does look like it's most of the area. Whatever we have to do to get up to that scaffold there. I might have another look next time, see if there's anything around, but I don't think I saw anything. And we do have a few of these stones around here that we need to light, just behind, and then a few up there, and then I believe we have a boss to fight. That does look then like it's most of the area, but it does appear to then go into, I'm assuming this is another forest and that these are trees on the map. Either that or boulders. So it's either a rocky area or a forested area. We haven't managed to get up to, again, it looks like you can probably get up to these bridges, possibly using that spirit jump thing down here, and then check out this area. And I assume you will have to get to the final boss. And this looks like it's just one big boss arena, maybe. I mean, maybe not even, it may not even be traversable. We know we can't swim, that's for certain, and this looks like shallow waters around the area. Yeah, we can see around the edges of the normal map, there's like a brightly coloured bit, and then the faded out areas are areas you can't swim to or anything, so it wouldn't surprise me if this is all just there for atmosphere to look at while you may be fighting some kind of boss around here or something like that. But we do have this to explore, and we know it's going to be a tough fight versus some snipers. And then we can return back, fight this big boss. I do wonder if that's going to take us to the area of the Crimson Rot. But after we've done all of that, we'll probably want to scout the other area up here and see which one we would prefer to go to. We've got a foothold here and we've just started scouting over there, so, but both are open to us, and we need to figure out which one we're more comfortable with. Because it would make more sense to go to that while we're weaker, and then the tougher one while we're when we're a bit stronger. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Over and a bit. You're welcome. I'll see you next time.